her toes. Picture me riding around in that rose. I put some ice on my wrist, it was swole. Still ain't got time to with you. I'm really just running for money. I'm Lil Flo Joe chasing a check. I'm really gonna run up the money. I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. I'm really just running for money. I'm Lil Flo Joe chasing a check. I'm really gonna run up the money. I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed.
Bigger the bag, bigger the beef, bigger the problem, bigger the be one of the all on the same. Broke it, end of the month, flow joke, kill mo, run it up, keep clean, never let them touch. Fits like temper tantrums, girl, come back that up. All in the club, and bring out your girlfriends, girl, hopping up about a Pearl 6. Louis speed bag glued to her wrist, she was getting paid. She ain't think a thing, but she was thinking slay. We blade thicker than a snigger bait. Talking about she don't come with no baggage. Y'all in her bag, I probably should.
I'm really just running for money. I'm Lil Flo Joe chasing a check. I'm really gonna run up the money. I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. I'm really just running for money. I'm Lil Flo Joe chasing a check. I'm really gonna run up the money. I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed.
We want back ends.
Wipe my sins.
They can't win.
No new friends.
Football fast.
They sleep again.
We wake them up
the champs is in.
Champion.
We want back ends.
Wipe my sins.
Wipe it.
They can't win.
No new friends.
Football fast.
They sleep again.
We wake them up.
The champs is in.
Yeah.
Wake up. The cake up, raise up, or make us do something we don't want to. Bite down on you, right now on you. Juke to the left, they dodging it. Can't play the role, you flogging it. Waiting on the right for the stars in it. 4x4, double parking it. Wanna play like cars in it. Where the right flag, they forfeit it. Now I got a ring too gorgeous. Damn, I gotta treat it like forges. It sound like I'm gonna scratch it. Try to take the ring, I'ma tackle you. I guess I'm a Super Bowl bachelor. Go hard in the gym, no cameras. I think I see blood, no Dracula. I'm an animal, eating up amateurs. Too active, y'all can't handle it. No taxing, we'll dismantle it. Taxi, shake up the building, they ramble it. With it, shut up the critics and analysts. Come through dripping, I'ma set it off.
Drip.
Game after game, you can bet it off. Quarterback got range if you block them all.
Range.
Quarterback did an option and set it off.
Duck, cool, slimebacker coming through.
Boom, yeah.
Hit him with the spin of the juice.
Boom.
Yeah, we gon' blow your block like a
new.
Yeah, and I spend a dime every two. We gon' lock down on the
skeleton fossil. Bust down. I'm not addressing the problem. Julio on the post, you can't stop him. Woo. Pick it up, running back, it's no problem. Pick it up. I'm running behind the block, they gon' block him. Quavo, Yoda, I'm offset, Chewbacca. Watch the blitz on the left, we gon' block him. We some animal, yeah, we some goblin. Man to man, we gon' cover you properly. Man to man, you can't beat me impossibly. Man to man, red zone, this my highlight, my property. Do a quarterback, niggas on 4th and 3. Kick the ends on the officer, block for me. I step on them down, get off of me. I'm trucking them over, he under me.
Walk back in.
Back in.
Wipe my sins.
Wipe my sins.
They can't win.
They can't win.
No new friends.
No new friends.
Football fast.
Football.
They sleep again.
They sleep.
We wake them up.
Wake up. The champs is in.
Champion.
We walk back in.
Back in.
Wipe my sins.
Wipe it. Wipe it.
They can't win.
They can't win.
No new friends.
No new friends.
Football fast.
Football.
They sleep again.
They sleep.
We wake them up.
Wake up, the champs is in.
Yeah, yeah.
I just hit the ball and I look for the open man.
Where?
The zone, I'm trying to get in.
Yeah.
Open the play, but the book of the champion.
Open.
Get picked if you trying to get in.
Yeah.
I got the front defense, they got the end.
Defense.
Going for long, on first and the 10.
Yeah.
Gotta go hard, we gotta get on. No loss or excuses, cause we gotta win.
Yeah.
They say they sleep, must not be a fan. Get
no.
at your mans and mess up your plans. Look at your stands and look at your hands.
I do
look
what
I want and you do what you can.
I
do it for fans, you do it for fame.
Yeah.
EA Sports, we in the game.
EA.
I am the coach and the player of the game. They gon' remember the name.
We walk back in.
Back in.
Wipe my sins.
Wipe my sins.
They can't win.
They can't win.
No new friends.
No new friends.
Football fast.
Football.
They sleep again.
They sleep.
We wake them up.
Wake up.
The champs is in.
Champion.
We walk back in.
Back in.
Wipe my sins.
Wipe it. Wipe it.
They can't win.
They can't win.
No new friends.
No new friends.
Football fast.
Football.
They sleep again.
They sleep.
We wake them up.
Wake up. The champs is in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sailing right now. I got too much on my mind right now. Show the hero tale, get my baby 35. I swear, baby, we just kissing us. How could I forget that you done gone for me? Baby, gonna take the charge and take the fall for me. Would love to take you shopping, but cause I'm in your time. So, little mama, I can give you more. Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sailing right now. Could you? I got too much on my mind right now. Hero Dale, get my baby 35.
Jack, when you coming back, where's you at on the mat? Everything is intact, could have been a seamstress, still wouldn't cut him slack. Pretty much ain't got a clue, itty bitty piggyback off everything I do. But I'm still dropping, got him looking like James Harden at the awards. Back to you, I'm so in to you, for real, real, like I'm keen to you. If you were 10, I add 10 to you. They be mad when I 10 to you, that's what the bay like. Call me Buffy, cause that's what I slay like. These, I sun them like it's daylight. These, wanna know what it's like. What it's like, yo, what it's like, yo. They wanna know.
Show the hero tale, get my baby 35.
supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. Hey. I think the Rari go faster without the roof.
Jim.
30, I might go around in 2 seconds. Up, I love how my money count on move. With attitude, I got a b to, and I dropped out of school. I'm going up, check my vertical. Man, I'm breaking every rule. TMZ harassing me, I got a camera crew. Whoa. I'm addicted to shopping, so everything brand new.
Everything brand new, yeah.
I'm friends with the jeweler, my diamonds like Shamu.
My diamonds like Shamu.
Hey, she like she applying shampoo.
Yeah.
Pretty face, she got a look.
She got a look, yeah.
Keep a few racks on me, I used to work in the factory. Been hating it, never bother me, I make they follow me. Teacher said that I'm a prodigy. When I'm shopping, I don't care what it's costing me. 10 bands, really, that ain't a lot to me. Turn up my swag to infinity.
All right, much appreciated, Coach, as we welcome all of you to our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tennessee Titans and the Indianapolis Colts. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And now he'll tuck it and run. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a second and 5.
Gone, 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 gone! Over, 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 over!
They'll run it here, this is Marlon Mack. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and 4 now.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And they'll look to avoid an early 3-and-out here on 3rd and 4. He'll drop to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
That throw's not going to get them a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. Well, and you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 46, and he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man to man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility is showing those hands. Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. 17 yards on that play for the Titans.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
The first red zone opportunity for the Titans. First and 10 at the 19. Thank you. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
Second down, Mariota. They'll roll him out right. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of four. Now third down. They rolled out of the pocket right, and I think he wanted a little something more out of that play, obviously. Instead, he hit a safety back.
It looked like two well-coached teams there, even though there was no yardage gain, because the offensive guys, they realized their quarterback was out of the pocket. All the receivers went to the right spots, tried to get in his sight line, tried to open themselves up. Just nowhere to go where they could gain yardage. How about the defensive guys, though? Did not lose leverage and kept their poise and made a really nice play.
And Succop will put this one right through. And the Titans hit the scoreboard first. It's 3-0. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get three.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays, and when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
The Colts offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Right back to him on first down. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 16 yards to pick up there. The Colts have a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit, thanking them for that much space to rumble.
And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On play action, they'll throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10 at their own 46. Now they'll run it on the toss. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Okay, let's just make this one simple. We know that the running game is not their thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive. On third down, Mariota. And he's got a man, Corey Davis. His first catch, good for 16 and a first. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11. From the shotgun, it's Mariota being chased out left. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. Now Mariota. It's caught on the right side of Snell. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
It's a good pickup of 7 yards, and now they're looking at second and goal. He'll get it up the middle, and he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. A great play there, hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. Ryan Succapon for the point after. Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through. And the lead grows to 10-0. Now here's Succop out to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. Spinning past him. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, right, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. It'll be a loss of one, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
All right, now, lucky 56, lucky 56. Set, green 39, green 39.
And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. To the 33-yard line. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Right back to him on first down. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Naeem Hines with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Colts able to get this back within a touchdown. Extra point up and through. And that'll cut it to 3 at 10-7. So just a three-point game now as they send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They're starting to put some space here. You know, first quarter, they didn't look so hot offensively. This second quarter, though, they've looked really good.
They've jumped in the saddle in a big way now, and now they're in full gallop. I mean, before, kind of camping around a little bit, right, trying to feel their way, not getting done what they wanted to. But somehow they put it together with play calling, execution, and now there's a pretty big gap.
And they'll look to make that gap even bigger here. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Finding some room at midfield. And finally brought down at the 43. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach, because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. They didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. And that's caught by Smith. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. And they convert on third with a gain of 22. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Now they go screen. It's complete. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
They'll give it to him up the middle. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you're over that. And he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. A great effort there with touchdown number 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. Extra point put through by Succop. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Now here's Succop out to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. Spinning away. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tummy.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
They begin the drive with Hines. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So a jump there defensively.
It's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
And that last penalty makes his third down play a little more interesting. 3rd and 5. They're going to look to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and cause a nice play for lost yardage.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. And they have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? 2 touchdowns on a field goal in their first 3 possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
Uncorks one for and this is caught. He got 29 yards that time. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just...
And he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. A great play there. On his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. Extra point try now for Succop. Extra point up and good by Succop. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Now here's Succop out to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Indianapolis right after this.
Lucky 56. Over, over, over. Over, over.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he finds a man on a crossing route. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And this time they're able to bottle him up as he'll stop him at the line of scrimmage. The tackle was by the Boston College product, Harold Landry.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading the play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Josh Hawkins with a pick. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Wait a second. They did not accept that after the incompletion. Your look is just as puzzled as mine.
I got nothing for you here. You have to take that penalty, don't you?
It's 3 yards. And some room for him there as he'll take this up to about the 15. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Give him 16 yards there, a Tennessee first down. Mariota now, 8 of 11 in this first half. He's got it first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Now a second down throw for Mariota. Flush to his right. Room to run past midfield. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. Mariota had an 87-yard run as a rookie. This one a bit less, but it is a first down. So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. On first and 10, here's Mariota. But when this ball's tipped and intercepted, Kentrell Bryce picks it. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10.
Lucky 56. Hurry up. Here we go. 3-19.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to, and his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. So we reach halftime here with the visiting Titans taking the lead into intermission. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. The Titans hold the lead, and they'll get the football first as the third quarter gets underway. And the Titans getting set to go. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. Working out of the gun, Mariota. Flushed out right, and they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Well, live to fight another down, right?
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you'll have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. On the give, this is Pettis. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. Throwing is Mariota. And this is going to be incomplete. Trying to get their tight end involved finally. That's the first time that they've looked his way. He's kind of been a forgotten man in this offensive scheme.
Yeah, didn't look his way at all in the first half. And I'll bet you the offensive coordinator made a note at the half and said, let's get him involved because he could be a big-time playmaker for us.
This is taken at the 10. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. Here's the Colts now as they get ready for their first possession on offense of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. On the right side, it's Hilton with a catch. And they're going to have this all the way down deep into Tennessee territory. A huge play that time for the Colts. 56 yards. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Hines. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. It's a loss of 2, now third down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to pass. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Derek Rivers in there to get him well behind the line of scrimmage. Gosh, it's a loss of 17, and it'll be fourth down. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe, and that will close the gap down to 14. So a good drive there to begin quarter number 3, but they're only able to shave 3 points off the lead.
Well, something's better than nothing, all right? They didn't play particularly well in the first half, but they definitely need him to step on the accelerator now and play a whole lot better.
And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. 22 yards on the pickup there. After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. There's a give now to Bettis. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Mariota now on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has absorbed the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Mariota from the gun on third down. Dancing to his left. And that is incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Now look at this, fourth and 12, and they're going to line up to go for it. They're indeed going. It's Mariota. Smith catches left side, and he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. A big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling. Mariota now, 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got this down to the 35. 10 more there and another first down.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Right back to him on first down. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. One.
From the red zone now, Mariota. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Nice job there after the setback. 11 yards, and now it's second and goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
Well, they made the play there, and I'll guarantee you their coaches and the other players are screaming at them about their pride. Come on, guys. He's already gotten in 3 times. You can't give up a 4th one. And on that play, they were able to make the stop.
And you knew they were going to go to him to try to get that 4th.
And why wouldn't they? It's not just getting the 4th. He's the hot hand, so to speak, right? The hot feet in this situation. And he knows how to find the end zone. That time, he just didn't get there.
Back now in Indianapolis. It's the Titans. They've got the football. They'll be looking to extend their lead here as we begin the 4th quarter. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he gets in, touchdown Tennessee. A great effort there, taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. extra point put through by Sucker, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Now here's Suckup out to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. And give them a gain of 37.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And now here is another interception. Picked off by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line. Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. Now it's a bootleg with Mariota. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. And now here's a timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. They'll run it now out of the gun. There he goes inside the 30. Touchdown, Titans! A big play there. 45 yards. And the interception by the Titans D leads to a touchdown. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And the Colts coming out now. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 49. What a nightmarish game he's having now. Six interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. They give it and they take it away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown six interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it three times.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. But they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is, don't go too fast, when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 24. Now they'll run it on the toss. A strong broken tackle on that one. And then they get him to the ground just shy of the 15. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. Now they'll run it on the toss. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. A great play there. A 16-yard touchdown run. And this Titan offense is running away with this one. Extra point up and good by Succop. And that will extend this big lead. Now here's Succop out to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Colts now, their offense works their way back onto the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on
all
the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
Now let's go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's got a rifle one deep left side. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Back to throw now on second and 10. Launching one for Henderson. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Carlos Henderson, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up third down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. you're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And some room to work. The Red Sea points, and there he goes. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he does get in for 6.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who's a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
And that's something you almost never see nowadays. When you fake it, you're at the 15-yard line on a PAT as opposed to just going for it from the 2.
I'm sorry. I know they got it, and congratulations to them, but it's just not a good play. I mean, the risk-reward is really off the charts. Not in your favor. Run your offense out there. Put it on the 2-yard line if you want to go for 2. But I'll be darned. They ended up getting that one, didn't they?
The Titans' offense now, they worked their way back onto the field. The outcome of this one, well, we know who's going to win it. It's just all window dressing at this point. Got me thinking, what's the biggest blowout that you've been a part of as a player, broadcaster?
No, I'm not going to go to the player part because when I think blowout,
because you won every game as a player.
No. I think about being blown out, and no one wants to go back to those memories. But, you know, when I was calling college football, I saw a game that, you know, a team put 70. I actually saw it happen twice. A team put 70 on their opponent. And in the NFL in the 2017 season, I saw one of those changing of the guard games where a team that hadn't been very good before now was dominating and kicking around a team who had been ruling their division.
And that's when you earn your paycheck, right? As the analyst, you got to fill that time.
You got to know what's going on out there and how it all happened.
Well, obviously, that begs the question, what game was it?
That was Seattle hosting Los Angeles. The Rams.
Ah, yeah.
Their second meeting of the season, and the Rams turned it around from the first one and blew out the Seahawks.
It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. Try and run for that first and goal. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. He'll get it up the middle, and they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. And, partner, are you kidding me? With this game that he's having, we are in uncharted waters like we've never seen before.
Just think, if he keeps every football from all the touchdowns scored today, does he need to build a new trophy room at home?
Yeah. A couple trophy rooms, maybe a whole home for trophy room.
What a phenomenal performance, and I'll guarantee you he's going to reward the rest of the offensive unit after this as well for helping him get to this number.
He better. This is just unreal. That'll be taken in the end zone. And some room to maneuver. And a very solid return out across the 45-yard line before going out of bounds.
Even after that big-time return, it's not looking great for them today. But if nothing else, even if the miracle doesn't happen, they can turn to this play and say, hey, we can move forward. Maybe it's a building block for the rest of the season.
They find some open field here. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 25 yards to pick up there, and also a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Give him 3 on the keeper there, and it is second down. Now they got to get to the line quickly.
And if you like defensive football, focus on the defensive end on this play. He does everything exactly right. Reads the play, and makes sure he spills it for a small gain.
3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go. On third down, here's an option play left. He can run for it, and he will. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Buying time to his left. He may try and run for this. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number 2. The Colts on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10. Looking to throw. And now here is another interception. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. 6 interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed, or are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. And another mistake here defensively as a flag is down on the tackle, and that's going to tack on 15 more. Give him 25 yards on the play there. So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll be taken down here, and that is how this one is going to come to an end. Of course, the game can't end with a defensive penalty, so they'll get one more crack.
So now you get an untimed play, which should be the last one, unless it happens again and there's another defensive penalty.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Into the secondary again. And did he get in? No, down at the one-yard line. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Tennessee, they move back over 500 at 3-2 now on the year. And they'll return home next week to take on the Detroit Lions. Meanwhile, for the Colts, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2.